Hi, I'm Pelipper, and this is Chunkman Only. Wait. This is an Iron Man series, so I'm supposed to have an intro with my character walking and the camera panning. Alright, give me a minute.
When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently that when she passes, each one she passes goes.
Hi, I'm Pelipper, and this is Chunk Man Only, my chunk restricted Iron Man account.
What's going on, everybody?
Chunk
Man Only here.
I recently saw Pookaguy's One Chunk Man series and was inspired to try a similar challenge. For those of you that are familiar with his series, the rules will be mostly familiar with a few changes, the biggest of which is that I'm allowed to choose my next chunk. If you care about the specifics of the rules, I'd watch this whole video, but if not, feel free to start by watching episode 1. The rules basically boil down to that I'm stuck in a small area of the map, and to unlock more of it, I have to complete everything in the area that I have unlocked already. So something that's important to me is to make sure that the rules are clearly defined and cover every possibility, so I'm going to start with some definitions. So while some items may be obtainable in a chunk, not all are as easy to get as others. So these items have been categorized into three different categories. First, we have primary items, which are items obtainable through a 100% drop rate of a gathering skill or monster drop, or through a shop or item spawn, whereas a secondary item is obtainable through a non-100% drop rate of a gathering skill or monster drop, more common than 1 in 1,000, and a tertiary item is an item obtainable through a 1 in 1,000 or rarer drop, random events, non-mole bird's nests, random drop table drops, clue scrolls, non-puro-puro implings, or other relatively inconsistent methods. Just like certain items are harder to get than others, certain training methods are more consistent than others, so they've been categorized. A time-locked training method is a method which has a time of over a minute to repeat, and the time cannot be reset by world hopping. Examples might include making battle stats obtained from Zaf, Tears of Guthix, or cooking sweet corn obtained by farming. A consistently repeatable training method is a non-time-locked training method which does not require any secondary or tertiary items. In the case of the farming skill, however, we have to get rid of the non-time-locked requirement, as everything in farming other than the tithe farm is time-locked. Best-in-slot item is the best item in its slot of a particular style of combat out of what is available, deemed by a best-in-slot calculator, or the best form of a tool like the highest-tier pickaxe or an axe. A chunk is an area of the world map designated by a map tile. The chunk extends its boundwards.
Rapidly moving on.
The chunk extends its boundaries upwards into above ground levels, and underground areas that are accessible from the chunk are considered part of the chunk. So the boundaries don't extend downwards. The whole underground area that is accessible is considered part of the chunk. An accessible chunk is a chunk adjacent to previously unlocked chunks that does not have physical boundaries separating them, or a chunk that's accessible through an unlocked non-teleport transportation method. If a chunk has a physical boundary inside of it, then the chunk is only considered accessible if there exists a non-completed goal inside of the chunk that is accessible. Okay, so now that we got through describing all of those definitions, now we can actually start talking about the rules that govern this account in a way that makes sense and is consistent. So after Tutorial Island, all of the items from the island are dropped, and the account is locked to the first chunk surrounding Lumbridge Castle. I can't move outside of the chunk or interact with anything outside of the chunk. And to move on, I need to unlock another chunk, which can be done by completing all of the goals within the boundaries that we are limited. So these goals are split up into different categories, and each category has its own specific rules. First, I'll talk about the rules that govern gathering skills, which includes woodcutting, hunter, thieving, fishing, runecrafting, and mining. So the highest level, primary, or secondary gathering skill items in the area must be obtained as long as a consistently repeatable training method to train the corresponding skill is unlocked, and it is not a repeat or a lower level item than has already been gathered earlier. So next is production skills, which includes fletching, cooking, fire making, smithing, and crafting. So all primary and secondary items that can be processed with production skills must be processed with each possible skill, as long as the items required to produce the product are primary or secondary, and a consistently repeatable training method to train the corresponding skill is unlocked, and that is not a repeat or a lower level item that has been produced earlier. All agility courses and shortcuts must be completed at least once, as long as a consistently repeatable training method for agility is unlocked and the level required is higher than a previously completed shortcut or course. So the Slayer rules are a little bit complicated, but I'll do my best to explain it. The highest tier Slayer monster must be slain, as long as it is not a lower level Slayer monster than one already slain or a repeat monster. A Slayer master must also be unlocked. For Slayer to be considered consistently repeatable, the current task must also be completable. If a task is not completable, all possible skips must be used to try and obtain completable tasks. If Toriel is unlocked, then Toriel skips must also be used. So basically what this means is, as long as I can do a Slayer task or get a Slayer task that I can do, I must keep training Slayer if there is a Slayer monster in my area that's unlocked that I haven't killed yet. So I hope that makes sense. All primary seeds must be farmed, as long as the corresponding patch is unlocked and it's not a lower level seed than one of the same type of patch used previously. So this means farming will rarely ever lock us to an area for an extended period of time, because this only really applies to seeds bought in stores. Only other time farming will lock us is for quest requirements. Since high level herbs and secondaries are relatively easy to obtain early on, and making potions really has no relation to the chunks that we're in, I decided to not give any special rules to herb lore, meaning it will not ever lock us other than for achievement diary and quest requirements. Because most of the construction content is inside of the instance of your house, I decided to not give any rules to construction, with one exception. If a house portal is unlocked and a consistently repeatable training method for construction is unlocked, then the level required to relocate the house to the new portal must be obtained. So all primary or secondary best in slot items must be obtained and equipped. In the case of tools, they must be obtained and we must have the level to use them. We also don't need to equip the tools. All quests must be progressed as far as possible, as long as a quest does not require a tertiary or unobtainable item, or a skill that has no consistently repeatable training method unlocked. So we measure progression in a quest by when the quest journal updates when an action is completed. So if an item is needed for a quest and we're able to obtain that item, if obtaining that item doesn't change the quest journal, then we don't need to get that item right away. But if we need to talk to someone and we can talk to them or give them an item and that progresses the quest, then we must do that. All achievement diary tasks must be completed, as long as the task does not require a tertiary or unobtainable item or a skill that has no consistently repeatable training method unlocked. Also, medium tasks are not required unless all the area's easy tasks are already completed or completable. And the same goes for hard tasks with medium and elite with hard. So basically, before we need to worry about the medium tasks, we need to have already completed the easy tasks. Before we need to worry about the hard tasks, we need to have already completed the medium tasks and so on. So here's where the main difference comes between my account and Pookaguy's account. After each chunk is completed, a new accessible chunk of my choice is unlocked and all the goals within it must be completed. Now I decided to do it this way instead of using a random number generator because I thought there would be more strategy involved, and I think it's more fun this way. I don't want to have to be locked into getting 70 smithing by smithing bronze bars or anything crazy like that. I want to be able to choose where I'm going to go next and strategize the best way for me to unlock things more quickly. So I think it'll be a lot of fun and I hope you guys do as well. In case some of the rules didn't make sense or you want to read over them, I've included a link in the description to a Google Doc with all the rules. Please go check out Pookaguy's channel if you haven't already. It's a really good idea that he had, and I'm very glad he came up with the idea. I'm going to have a lot of fun with this account, and I know a lot of other people are doing a similar type of account. So thanks so much for having this idea, man. It's really good. So yeah, that about does it for the rules. I hope it all made sense. If it doesn't, feel free to leave a comment asking a question, and I'll do my best to explain it. And if you find some kind of logical inconsistency or something that I missed, feel free to let me know. I hope you enjoyed this and look forward to episode 1. Please give the video a like and subscribe. It really helped me out. Thanks for watching. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so